Superintendent, I know this has to be just a horrible day, a nightmare for everybody. Tell me what you know at this point.
Well, first, I can't tell you that we can't do anything other than put our prayers out for the families, the students in the school, and this community. It's just a heartbreaking tragedy. What we do know at this point is that every single law enforcement entity in Broward County is on the scene, including the FBI. There are fatalities that are involved. We can't confirm the number at this point. I am in communication with Sheriff Scott Israel. I'm going to meet with him now. Have been in communication with the governor. Everyone is providing the full support that they can. Unconfirmed reports now, but we believe that the shooter has been apprehended. And so we're trying to just work through all the details at this point.
Can you tell me the scenario we're hearing is this former student entered the freshman building? Is that your understanding?
I don't know the details of where the student entered, but we do know that it occurred during dismissal time. And yes, it is potentially some former student. Don't have a name yet. I can't release any information to you. But that individual, we believe, is in custody at the moment.
We hear a high number of casualties. Are you getting any indication from the sheriff just how many people may have died?
Can't confirm the number at this point, but there are fatalities involved here.
Can you tell us at least how many transports? Do you know maybe a dozen?
I don't know the number that's been transported at this point, but again, there are numerous fatalities. It's a horrific situation. It's just a horrible day for us. And
we got reports of multiple shootings. Can you confirm that?
I'm sorry, what's that?
That there were more than one shooter.
No, at this point, we have no evidence that there's been more than one shooter. The individual, again, we believe has been apprehended. I would leave it to the sheriff to provide you additional details around that.
Mr. Runcie.
They saw a teacher who was dead. Is that confirmed by you, a teacher shot?
I believe there's an administrator or teacher that is involved. There may be more. I can't confirm if that's been one of the fatalities at the moment.
Superintendent, this is a day I'm sure every superintendent fears to happen here in Broward.
It's a day that you pray every day I get up that we will never have to see. It is in front of us, and I ask the community for your prayers, your support for these children and their families. We're going to do whatever we can to come together as a community to pull through this, and we will. And again, we're doing everything we possibly can. The students are being evacuated and released at the moment, so we're working through that process right now.
Are you aware of any indication, any warning, any hint that the students could have been planning?
We've received no warning, no indication, but again, there's going to be a thorough investigation. Typically, you see in these situations that there potentially could have been signs out there. I would be speculating at this point if there were, but we didn't have any warnings. There weren't any phone calls or threats that we know of that were made.
Superintendent, there's so many parents that are afraid to send their kids to school. What would you tell them out there?
Well, what I would say is that we cannot live in a world that's built on fear. We have to do what we can to make sure that we provide the greatest safety measures we can for our kids. But what I'll tell you is that mental health issues.
Superintendent Robert Runcie right there of that school district down in South Florida, Parkland, Florida.